वेलकम टू द महात्मा गांधी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्निकल एजुकेशन एंड रिसर्च सेंटर। इन 2004, अ नेशनल लेवल इंस्टीट्यूट एमजीटा हैज बीन स्टार्टेड इन द फील्ड ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी एज पर गाइडलाइंस ऑफ ऑल इंडिया काउंसिल फॉर टेक्निकल एजुकेशन AICTE न्यू डेली। एमजीटा इज अप्रूव्ड बाई AICTE न्यू डेली गुजरात स्टेट एंड अफिलिएटेड टू गुजरात टेक्नोलॉजिकल यूनिवर्सिटी अहमदाबाद विच इज ऑल्सो नॉन as GTU. Our goal is to be an institute of generative ideas so that we remain relevant to our society. The MGTA has always been an organization on move with continuous effort on improving its processes and to maintain its relevance to the Indian science scenario, with adding new programs in its programmatic portfolio. We strongly believe in overall development of students, so for that we provide them a different platform like state level tech fest, project fair, different sports activity, which helps students to teach teamwork and problem solving skills, to get physical health benefits, boost self esteem and reduce pressure and stress for prove their skills in distinct area. Welcome to the lecture of Power System Operation and Control. Myself, Professor Gaurang C. Patel from Mahatma Gandhi Institute of Technical Education and Research Center, Navsari. Student, today we are going to discuss of chapter number 1, that is automatic generation and voltage control. And this chapter we are discussing in detail, that is understanding of load frequency control. So let's we'll begin our lecture session. This lecture we have learned about the automatic generation control. So student, today we are going to discuss regarding the load frequency control. Okay, so what is load frequency control? That we will see in this lecture session. So before going for that is we discuss or we just revise the thing that what we had learned in the last lecture, that is automatic generation control. Because if you don't have the clear concept of automatic generation control, then there is no meaning to go further. Okay, so automatic generation control mein hum kya karte the pehle to. Why we need the automatic generation control? Because कि अब जो हमारा load है वो दिन ब दिन बढ़ता जा रहा है, ठीक है, तो उसको manually control करना, that is not the convenient method. So that's why we are switched over to the automatic generation control, because there are a number of generation unit will be there who is producing the power, and we need to control that power flow with the automation. Okay, because it is fast, reliable, because today's need of the consumer, that is the reliability. Okay, if we are not providing the reliability, then we lose the trust and we lose the market as well. Okay, so that's why reliability is the first factor to satisfy our consumers. Okay, so that's why we need the automatic control. Now what is the load frequency control over here? Because load, we know that what is the load. There are three things in the power system. First of all, there is a generation unit, then transmission and distribution unit, and the third one, that is the load. Okay, load, that is us. Okay, ki bhai jo electricity ka use kar rahe hain wo kitna use kar rahe hain, that is the load. Okay, so that frequency is also depends on the generation frequency, because each and everything is related to each other. Okay, and once we control the generator side frequency, but it is not easy to control the load frequency. Okay, because our load is varying each and every hour, or you can say each and every minute. Okay, वी कैन नॉट कंट्रोल द लोड साइड, क्योंकि भाई हमें नहीं पता होता कि किस आदमी को या किस यूनिट को किस एरिया को कौन से वक्त कितनी इलेक्ट्रिसिटी चाहिए. फॉर एग्जाम्पल हम GIDC हमारे सूरत की या उधना GIDC की बात करें, नवसारी GIDC की बात करें, तो सम ऑफ इंडस्ट्री इज हैविंग अ स्टार्टिंग टाइम ऑफ 7 o'clock, सम ऑफ देम हैविंग अ 8 o'clock, सम ऑफ देम हैविंग अ 9 o'clock और 10 o'clock, एंड देन अदर इफ वी आर talking about our colleges, universities, so those time is also different. So each and every person requirement is the different. So we cannot predict at which time how much load will be there. So that will affect also at the generation side. So we need to
control the load frequency as well to protect the generator area. Okay, so that's why we learn here for the load frequency control. Okay, so let us start with the theory for the load frequency control for single area case. Okay, first of all, we will learn the single area case. Now, student, what is the single area case and what is the two area case or multi area case? Okay, single area case, that means now we are right now what we are assuming that we have only one generator unit. Okay, कि भाई हमारे पास सिर्फ एक जनरेटर यूनिट है और उस जनरेटर यूनिट से हम एक एरिया को पावर फीड कर रहे हैं. ओके, बट इन रियल केस, इन प्रैक्टिकली, देयर इज नॉट ओनली वन जनरेटर, देयर इज अ नंबर ऑफ जनरेशन यूनिट दैट विल प्रोवाइड अ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी टू डिफरेंट एरियाज. ओके, दैट वी नो, बट हियर फॉर द सिंप्लिसिटी एंड द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द चैप्टर वी आर कंसिडर ओवर हियर, दैट इज अ सिंगल एरिया केस. इन सिंगल एरिया केस देयर इज ओनली वन जनरेटर that will provide a supply to a particular area. Okay, now let us consider the problem of controlling the power output of the generators of the closely knit electric area so as to maintain the scheduled frequency. Okay, now all the generators in such an area constitute a coherent group so that all the generators speed up and slow down together, maintaining their relative power angles. Now if you consider more than one generator, but in single area case, one of the thing you have to keep in mind that अगर हम एक से ज्यादा generator का use कर रहे हैं तो भी सभी generator के frequency, voltage and power that will going we should have to keep them remain at same level. Okay, तीनों का जो भी parameter है हमारा important parameter, voltage, frequency and that power, that should be remain same for the each and every generator. That is also considering in the single area case. Okay, now such an area is defined as a control area. The boundaries of a control area will generally coincide with that of an individual electricity board. To understand the load frequency control problem, let us consider a single turbo generator system supplying an isolated load. Okay, now it is the fundamental of speed governing system. Let us see, that is the figure of speed governing system. Just a moment. Okay, student, now you can see it is a speed governing system. Okay, some of the parts, it is, first of all, we will start with the speed changer. You can see over here, this is the speed changer. ओके, वन लिंक इज कनेक्टेड ओवर, और एक लिंक यहाँ पे जुड़ा हुआ है स्टूडेंट. ये ब्लू कलर का जो है, दैट इज द लिंक. यू कैन सी दिस इज अ पार्ट L1, L2, L3 एंड L4. वन लिंक इज कनेक्टेड विद द सिस्टम. उस लिंक के साथ क्या जुड़ा हुआ है, यहाँ पे एक स्प्रिंग जैसा आपको मैकेनिज्म दिखाई दे रहा है. ओके, दिस टू आर द फ्लाई बॉल्स. दिस इज नोन एज द फ्लाई बॉल विच इज कनेक्टेड टू दिस लिंक, एंड वी आर डिनोटेड दिस लिंक इट इज एन XB. ओके, फोर पार्ट्स में डिवाइड किया गया है, फाइव पार्ट्स में, ए बी सी डी एंड ई. लिंक के फाइव जो भी कनेक्शन है उसको इस तरह से डिवाइड किया गया है, ए बी सी डी एंड ई. उसमें पहला जो पार्ट है दैट वी विल सी, दैट इज द स्पीड गवर्नर. ओके, इट इज, दिस पार्ट इज नॉन एज द स्पीड गवर्नर. ओके, नाउ if we move further, another parts you can see, it is the pilot valve. Okay, this portion, that is known as the pilot valve. Here you can see this portion is known as a high pressure oil. Okay, this is the high pressure oil, this is the pilot valve, and the mechanism you can see, this is the one rod is connected over here and which will move upwards and downwards with the help of this link. जब ये link movement करेगा, okay, तब ये जो road है वो up और down उसका movement होगा. Okay, this is the hole, you can see, it is a pilot valve. This is a pilot valve which is control the flow of your high pressure oil. Okay, now over here it is a hydraulic amplifier. Now according to the flow of high pressure oil, this piston will move your दिस रोड एज पर द हाई प्रेशर ऑयल प्रेशर. ओके, अगर इसका प्रेशर ज्यादा होगा तो ये थोड़ा सा आगे जाएगा. ओके, ये पिस्टन और ये जो आपका जो वाल्व है वो ऊपर की साइड शिफ्ट होगा. ओके, नाउ वन बाय वन वी विल सी दिस इज द स्टीम. स्टीम इज फ्लोइंग टूवर्ड्स दैट. ओके, जितना ये यहाँ से ओपन और क्लोज होगा इतना यहाँ से स्टीम टर्बाइन की ब्लेड पे उसका फ्लो उस तरह से बढ़ेगा और कम होगा. ओके, सो हाउ इट विल बी ऑपरेट दैट वी विल सी. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल हियर दैट इज द लोअर आर्म एंड हियर दैट इज द रेजिंग आर्म. ओके, एंड दिस इज द स्पीड चेंजर यूनिट. सो सबसे पहले हम सिंपली उसको अंडरस्टैंड करेंगे कि भाई जब भी आप इस आर्म को लोअर पोजीशन में ले जाते हैं, अगर ये जो स्पीड चेंजर आर्म है इफ वी मूव डाउनवर्ड्स ओवर हियर दैट मींस दिस योर एक्स बी इज गोइंग टू बी अपवर्ड. ओके, सो दैट योर फ्लाई बॉल इज गोइंग टू बी ओवर हियर. ये यहाँ पे सिकुड़ेगा और या तो आप कह सकेंगे कि उसका लेंथ यहाँ से कम होगा तो क्या होगा, उसकी वजह से आपका जो प्रेशर ऑयल है यहाँ से ज्यादा यहाँ से फ्लो होगा. ओके, नाउ इफ वी रेज द आर्म देन दिस आर्म इज गोइंग टू बी शिफ्टेड डाउनवर्ड्स. ओके, एंड योर फ्लाई बॉल इज गोइंग टू बी एक्सपांडेड एंड ड्यू टू दैट द प्रेशर ऑफ ऑयल इज गोइंग टू बी लो. ओके, सिमिलरली इफ द प्रेशर ऑफ ऑयल इज गोइंग टू बी लो देन योर आर्म एक्स डी That is going to be shifted. Okay, अगर ये ऊपर जाएगा तो क्या होगा कि आपका जो XC है वो नीचे आएगा. If XC is come downwards, then your XD is going to be upward. ठीक है, ये आपका XB अगर नीचे गया then XC is going to be upward and XD is going to be downward and it will control the high pressure oil. Now if it is going to be downward, then it is going to be shifted and this will be क्लोज द टर्बाइन वाल्व. ओके, अगर जितना भी आपको इसको नीचे लाना है तो क्या करना पड़ेगा, एक्स डी को यहाँ से ऊपर लाना पड़ेगा, देन इट विल बी कम डाउनवर्ड्स ओवर हियर. सो दैट्स हाउ योर स्पीड गवर्निंग सिस्टम इज गोइंग टू बी वर्क. द थियरी इज गिवन ओवर हियर. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल सी. नाउ फिगर शोज स्कीमेटिकली द स्पीड गवर्निंग सिस्टम ऑफ अ स्टीम टर्बाइन. द सिस्टम कंसिस्ट ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कंपोनेंट्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दैट इज द फ्लाई बॉल स्पीड गवर्नर. दिस इज द हार्ट ऑफ द सिस्टम विच सेंसेस द चेंज इन स्पीड. ओके, ये जो फ्लाई बॉल स्पीड गवर्नर है आपका, दिस इज द फ्लाई बॉल स्पीड गवर्नर सिस्टम. दिस इज द फ्लाई बॉल स्पीड गवर्नर सिस्टम. ओके, सो वॉट इट विल बी सेज, this is the heart of the system which senses the change in speed or frequency. As the speed increases, the flyball moves outwards. Okay, jaise hi aapki speed badhti hai aapka jo ye flyball mechanism hai that will move outwards, yani ye expand hoga, is tarah se expand hoga. Okay, so flyball moves outwards and the point B on linkage mechanism move downwards. Aapka jo ye point B hai that is XB, पॉइंट बी इज गोइंग टू बी डाउनवर्ड्स. ये यहाँ से नीचे आएगा तभी तो ये एक्सपांड हो पाएगा. ठीक है, व्हेन एक्स बी इज गोइंग टू बी डाउनवर्ड्स योर मैकेनिज्म इज गोइंग टू बी एक्सपांडेड. ओके, सो द रिवर्स हैपन्स व्हेन द स्पीड डिक्रीजेस. ओके, जब स्पीड कम होगी तो रिवर्स मोमेंट होगा. ओके, अगर स्पीड इफ फर्स्ट फिर से हम एक बार स्टेटमेंट देख लेते हैं. ओके, एज द स्पीड इंक्रीजेस, किसकी स्पीड, आपके टर्बाइन की स्पीड. ओके, आपके एज द स्पीड इंक्रीजेस द फ्लाई बॉल्स मूव आउटवर्ड्स. एज द स्पीड इंक्रीजेस योर फ्लाई बॉल मूव्स आउटवर्ड्स. ओके, एंड एज द स्पीड डिक्रीजेस योर फ्लाई बॉल मूव इनवर्ड्स. ओके, सो आउटवर्ड्स में ये जो बी मैकेनिज्म है वो डाउनवर्ड्स आएगा और इनवर्ड्स में ये बी मैकेनिज्म है वो आप लिंक पे ध्यान रखिएगा. ये जो लिंक, एक लिंक अपवर्ड या डाउनवर्ड होती है तो उसकी वजह से पूरी लिंक के पोजीशन पे क्या डिफरेंस आएगा. ठीक है, अगर ये डाउनवर्ड होती है दैट मींस आपका जो एक्सी है वो अपवर्ड आएगा. वो अपवर्ड होता है तो आपका एक्सडी है वो डाउनवर्ड जाएगा. ये डाउनवर्ड जाएगा तो ये अपवर्ड जाएगा. ओके, कैन यू गेट इट. सो इफ योर स्पीड इज इंक्रीजेस देन योर एक्सबी इज गोइंग टू बी downwards. If your XB is going to be downward, then this whole mechanism is going to be, you can see XC is upward, then XD is downward, and XD is downward, then your XC is going to be upward. यानी speed आपके increase हो रही है, तो वो आपको speed कम कैसे करेगा, कि ये जो आपका जो ये valve है, वो close होगा, तो यहाँ जो steam flow होगा turbine पे, उसकी speed कम होगी, तो turbine की speed कम होगी, ठीक है? तो इस तरह से आप ज़्यादा जो speed हो रही थी turbine को, उस speed को आप control कर सकेंगे. Similarly, if process is reversed, what we should do, we must have to open this valve, or we must have to provide the more space to throw the steam on the blade of turbine, okay? So that will be possible with same speed governor mechanism, okay? So another part, that is hydraulic amplifier, okay? So where is hydraulic amplifier? You can see it is the hydraulic amplifier. This is the hydraulic amplifier, students. You can see over here, hydraulic amplifier. Now, what is the function of hydraulic amplifier? Okay, so hydraulic amplifier, that is a rigid link pivoted at B and C, D, E. Okay, that is the hydraulic amplifier, and it is link provided with this particular, it will see B and C, D, E. Okay, so what is the function of hydraulic amplifier? This is the second one, hydraulic amplifier. It comprises a pilot valve and main piston arrangement. Hydraulic amplifier comprises a pilot valve and main piston arrangement. So where is main piston arrangement? This is the main piston arrangement, and it is the valve. Okay, this is the main piston arrangement, and it is the pilot valve. You can see this is the pilot valve, and it is the main piston arrangement. So your hydraulic amplifier is made up with, or it consisting of, main piston and pilot valve. Now what is the function that we will see? Low power level pilot valve movement is converted into high power level piston valve movement. That means low power level pilot valve movement, if your pilot valve have the low power, that means what will be the action take place? Low power level pilot valve movement is converted into high power level piston valve movement. This is necessary in order to open or close the system valve against the high pressure steam. Okay, then third one, that is the linkage mechanism. You can see this is known as the linkage mechanism. Now what is the function of linkage mechanism? Now linkage mechanism ABC is a rigid link provided at B. So this is the ABC, this is the point A, B and C. Okay, this is the first part they are going to be divided, that is ABC. And what is the function of that? It is provided at B, and CDE is another rigid link. So this is talking about the C, D and E. This is the another rigid link provided at D. So it is provided linkage mechanism. Okay, so that is ABC is a rigid link provided to B, and CDE is another rigid link provided at D. Now this linkage mechanism provides a movement to the control valve in proportion to change in speed. It also provides a feedback from the steam valve movement. So what is the function of this linkage valve? That is given in theory part. It will provide the signal, or you can say it will make this valve of turbine to open and close to control the speed, either if we want to increase the speed or either if we want to decrease the speed. According to that, it will take an action and it will make this function possible. Okay, and final one, that is the speed changer. Now where is the speed changer? We will see in the figure over here. That is the speed changer mechanism. Okay, if you lower or raise the arm, so it, according to that, it will be change the speed. So speed changer, it provides a steady state power output setting for the turbine. Its downward movement opens the upper pilot valve. Okay, that downward movement, that means if it is a downward movement, that means it will, when it will be downwards, what will be says It provides the steady state power output setting for the turbine. Its downward movement opens the upper pilot valve. Okay, so upper pilot valve is there. It is your upper pilot valve. This is your upper pilot valve. Okay, so downward movements is open the upper the your pilot valve, so that that more steam is admitted to the turbine under steady condition, hence more steady power output, and the reverse happens for upward movement for speed changer. Okay, so that's how this speed changer is going to be work. So if it will be downward, then your speed if is higher, and if it will be upwards, then your speed will going to be decreased. Okay, and that's how it will make your possible to steady state or control the speed of your turbine. Okay, so I hope you understood the working of speed governing system, and this question is almost every time asked in examination, speed governing system, as well as in previous lecture, automatic generation control system. Two of them are repeatedly asked. If you see the previous year papers, you can see these two questions are repeatedly asked in examination. Okay, so I hope you can make understand these two theories with the lecture, with the help of this lecture. So for today's lecture, we will take up to this, and next session we will be continuing the next lecture session. Okay, so thank you, students. So students, finally, as in every lecture, after completion of every lecture, I will try to give you a message that please remember turn off the light when it is not required. Okay, so please save the energy, save the electricity. Thank you very much.